terus sesuatu untuk membuka mata masyarakat biar itu memang diharuskan waria itu manusia ciptaan Tuhan, kita harus ingat kepada Tuhan, berterima kasih kepada Tuhan bahwa kita diciptakan dengan Tuhan. Dari yang Kristiani, Konghucu, Hindu itu harus bisa menjalankan menurut keyakinan mereka masing-masing. Tapi ternyata kalau waria itu ingin manusia ingin belajar beribadah di mana tempatnya, kalau waria mau ingin belajar beribadah ke pondok pesantren, mungkin 100% tidak bisa diterima. Mungkin 100% dipandang yang negatif saja. Ya, sini tempat untuk beribadah waria, juga untuk tempat belajar beribadah waria.
A waria is an Indonesian transsexual. Derived from the words wanita, meaning woman, and pria, man, waria are known as Indonesia's third sex. This centuries-old tradition is largely accepted as part of Indonesian culture. However, it's one that doesn't sit easily with Islam, which has risen to become the country's dominant religion since its arrival in the 13th century. Since Islamic law acknowledges only two sexes, male and female, and forbids men to dress and adopt the mannerisms of women, waria have been pushed further and further into the margins of society. This makes it difficult to practice their faith. While it seems strange that the waria are passionate about a religion that shuns them, they believe that even if the majority of Islamic authorities don't accept them, God does. I headed out to meet Mariani, a 50-year-old transsexual who runs a Senin Karma school from the back of her beauty salon, and is mother to her adopted daughter Rizky, who she raises on her own. Mariani greeted my translator Mendez and myself at the door and asked us to come in quietly as we had arrived in the middle of a Quran class.
Saya lahir di Yogyakarta tanggal 15 Agustus bulan 1960. Saya usia 51. Saya sekitar umur 14-13 saya sudah pakai bahasa sekolah, belum sampai SD saya sudah keluar lepas dari orang tua, saya mencari nafkah sendiri. Sudah saya jalankan yang keluar malam sampai ngamen semua sudah saya jalankan. Itu memang banyak waktu dulu ya.
As I talked with her more, Mariani told me about her life. Despite living through some tough times, she also had a lot of fun when she was younger. She used to be the singer in a dangdut band, which is Indonesia's sexy style of pop music. And from her description, it sounded like her career was a big deal. That all changed when she converted to Islam in her 30s. She left behind her hedonistic lifestyle to focus on her spirituality, because, as she puts it, her conversion came from the heart.
أَفَمَنْ يَعْلَمُ أَنَّمَا أُنْزِلَ إِلَيْكَ.
Ada komunitas-komunitas yang lain yang mengharamkan status mereka, maka saya atas nama pribadi, saya berani mengatakan bahwa pesantren ini halal. Berkecimpung di sini, saya aktif di sini itu sejak kurang lebih 2-3 bulan yang lalu. Karena saya merasa terpanggil jiwa saya, ketika mereka ini membutuhkan bimbingan, mereka sangat haus spiritual, mereka sangat haus agama.
Tapi sabar itu sederhananya begini, kalau kita ditimpa musibah, diam saja, dan sabar itu bisa menghilangkan dosa.
Following the 2006 earthquake that rocked Yogyakarta, Mariani gathered lots of her friends to participate in some of the mass prayers. An older priest friend was so impressed by her efforts and ability to draw a large group that he invited her to start a place for the transvestites to gather, and thus the school was born.
Untuk bisa waria bisa diterima kepribadian waria, diterima sebenarnya waria.
I was enjoying hanging out with Mariani and wanted to spend some more time talking to her one-on-one. But unexpectedly, she asked me if I'd like to attend the funeral of a waria who recently died from HIV complications. She told me that it would help me understand some of the difficulties they face. I agreed and we hopped in the car. Mariani's friend Unisara, who is a member of the school, caught a ride with us to the funeral.
Oh!
She pulled out her phone and started showing me photos of her main squeeze.
My husband.
Your husband.
Tapi sekarang dia sudah married dengan perempuan. Oh.
What? Nah, saya sudah tidak married.
He's already married with
him. Yeah.
He's married to a woman.
Yeah.
And Mbak Mariani boyfriend also already married with a woman.
Itu oh, really? Kalau yang saya married kan, yang melamarkan saya. Okay. Oh ya, waktu itu saya sampai pingsan karena
awalnya
saya pingsan melamarkan karena saya merasa kalau saya perempuan asli mungkin bisa begini. Saya maunya persaudaraan. Setelah tidak saya punya perasaan bahwa saya punya cowok tidak akan sama saya selamanya karena saya seorang waria, dia seorang cowok harus punya keturunan.
Do you do your own makeup?
Oh yeah.
You do eyeliner better than I do.
Oh, yeah.
Much better. Thank you.
The funeral was held in the street of a warrior-friendly community. Most of the local townspeople were sitting around and milling about, waiting for the ceremony to get underway.
Wow.
There was also a huge amount of warriors sitting around, smoking cigarettes and chatting. I'd seen photos of the warriors and knew they had distinctive faces, but seeing them in the flesh and dressed rather provocatively was overwhelming.
Saya seorang waria, saya bisa sopan santun, bisa menurut peraturan di masyarakat. Oh, saya seorang waria, saya harus berdandan merop, pakai bulu mata, pakai gantung satu, pakai rok mini, itu kan sudah tidak selayaknya di kampung. Sedangkan perempuan asli saja kadang-kadang di masyarakat bisa untuk perhatian masyarakat, apalagi seorang waria, siapa yang untuk semua masyarakat itu.
Bantuan yang sebesar-besarnya tidak bisa kita akan membalas dari warga kampung sini.
Mariani made a speech about the importance of warriors acting with dignity and self-respect in order to be seen as equal members of society. She encouraged them to contribute to the funeral costs of warriors that pass away. However, most of the warriors didn't seem to be paying much attention to what she was saying. They gave off the impression that a funeral is just business as usual. And in fact, it wasn't that far off. Usually 4 warriors die each month, mostly from the things that Mariani was trying to warn against in her speech.
Ayana sola, ayana sola, ayana lfala, ayana lfala, la ilaha illallah. Bunga.
Itu ya, siapa dia itu?
Bunga.
Dia waria dari luar kota.
Dari Medan.
Medan. Okay.
Teman-teman, khususnya bagi teman-teman yang masih aktif bekerja malam, itu mereka memang pola hidupnya jadi kurang tertata, seperti sering begadang, terus nanti selesai begadang juga kadang itu menimbulkan banyak sekali dengan kesehatannya. Dan sempat juga mengamen melihat kondisi sekarang di keluar malam itu kan sepi tamu, terus sempat mengamen juga.
Could you, while we're here, take us to see some of the street performers?
Oh bisa.
Bisa. Iya.
Sama ya. Saya enggak anu kok
iya.
Nanti saya biar, sama Pak Yes kita
iya,
sana
ikut mengantarkan.
We headed back to our hotel to rest up for the night and prepared to set out in the morning to meet up with some of Mariani's street singer friends.
Ada yang kebanyakan kalau waria dari luar malam dulu karena dia keluar dari rumah tanpa ada bekal apa-apa. Waktu dulu memang waktu saya keluar pertama ya memang banyak cibiran masyarakat, ada waria keluar itu dikatakan itu banci. Mengalih ke ngamen yang luar malam itu karena kalau ngamen itu memang bisa dipastikan mendapat, kadang-kadang sehari bisa mendapat 100.
I went to meet 2 friends of Mariani's, Jamila and Wulan, who work as street singers in central Yogyakarta. When I got there, I realized I had met them the day before at the school, but then they had been dressed as men.
Hello. tahun 82. Di jalan selagi sama-sama untuk jadi pekerja seks.
So you used to work as a prostitute and now you work as a street performer.
Lebih bahagianya daripada jadi pekerja seks.
Kalau aku nyanyinya favoritnya dangdut sama campur sari. Yang enak digoyang kan dangdut.
Aku tak mau ewer.
I've got that stuck in my head now. Oh, wow.
Kalau yang seneng ikut goyang, kalau yang enggak seneng kadang-kadang memang berjibir, kadang-kadang ada baju amen lewat, kayak ada yang dah, ada yang ya makanya ada yang enggak seneng kan kadang-kadang efeknya lain.
Some people got angry when the warriors approached and shooed them away, while others happily gave them money. Virtually everyone stared. One small boy burst into tears and started screaming. That was really intense. We were just up there and the girls were singing and this little kid totally fucking flipped out and started screaming when he saw them. And the mother like grabbed the kid and was really angry. Their reaction was really, really, like the mother was furious that the kid was so upset and the kid looked like he'd seen the devil or something.
Yeah.
After spending time with the warriors, I began to forget that their appearance could be alarming at first. As I watched people's reactions and the mockery they endured, I felt a huge amount of empathy for them.
Sampai malam ya, sampai
200. Tergantung kaki kita jalan. Kalau aku pas di rumah aku dekat Meguat, lapangan terbang. Cuman kalau sore, kalau hari libur, kalau nggak hari libur nggak berani.
While street performing seems like a dream job compared to prostitution, the downside is that the hours are long and enduring the noise and grit of Yogyakarta is tough. The negatives of working as a prostitute are obvious and a lot more dangerous.
Itu ya sekitar umur 14-15 itu saya sudah sampai saya keluar malam di alun-alun. Waktu dulu dapat 2.000, 3.000 udah banyak banget. Bayaran sekarang kan ada yang 20, 25, nggak tentu. Jadi sampai dipukul pakai pistol, tangan saya sampai ditelanjangin, dikencingin muka saya, itu sudah pernah saya rasakan hal seperti itu. Pernah saya alami, waktu itu saya belum tahu, karena keluar malam itu gimana ada resiko.
That night I planned to meet up with Novi and Nur, who work as prostitutes. Nur, who's only 19, read about Mariani and the school on the internet and traveled all the way from Lombok, which is a small island near Bali, to meet her.
Dengan tujuan saya kesini, ke Jogja itu sendiri dan tidak sama teman atau siapa sendiri gitu langsung diterima sama Ibu Mariani. Ya. Soalnya di sana sangat Islamnya sangat fanatik, jadi kalau kita keluar sedikit dicuekin, dicemohin sama orang. Jadi
do you miss your family or you happy to be away from them?
Kebetulan saya sudah nggak punya orang tua terakhir bulan 2010 kemarin, jadi ya kebetulan dengan bertemunya saya komunitas baru ini dan tentunya bergabung dengan pondok pesantren juga, saya anggap itu adalah keluarga saya yang baru, jadi sangat nyaman banget.
What would you like to do with your life?
Sebenarnya dalam tahap-tahap ini saya lagi sedang kursus salon, jadi untuk kedepannya insya Allah saya akan membuka salon dengan sekuat tenaga saya bekerja biar bisa buka salon.
That's great. I hope you can. We gave the girls a ride to their regular hooking spot, which was in a sketchy area next to a railway station. I'd heard stories of Wari being hit by trains while working in this location. Is it safe working here?
Selama saya di sini belum ada maksudnya kekerasan dengan preman-preman itu.
Kalau mangkal ya sekitar sini aja. Sekarang duduk-duduk di situ.
duduk di situ di ini loh, di besi-besi itu biasanya nongkrong sama anak-anak gitu. Sekarang di depan parkir itu tadi, di sekitar parkir itu mundur-mandir situ aja.
So that's where most of the customers hang out down there.
Iya, yeah, biasanya kan di sana. Tapi saya sukanya di sini, kalau di sini mungkin kalau di sana kan mungkin mereka harganya kan lebih murah di sana.
Iya. Yeah.
The girls stood for a while by the train tracks, but didn't get any customers. They decided to head over to a busier street they also regularly work. We hung out across the road, away from potential customers, so that the girls could do their thing. A few guys approached here and there, but for the most part, nothing really happened. The girls drank booze with a shopkeeper, practiced their poses, and played with their phones. After a few hours, it didn't look like they were going to have much luck tonight.
It's about midnight now. We've just been standing across the other side of the road to let the girls kind of do their thing and try and get some customers. I don't know, I just don't know how they do it. Like, you know, like Noor was saying, she just wants to go out tonight and work so that she can have some money to get through tomorrow. They definitely have dreams and things they want to do in the future and stuff, but they can only think this far. They can't really plan. It's very much in the day for them. Anyway, it's time to go home. I'm going to go across the road now and say goodbye to the girls and wish them good luck for tonight. I hope they make some cash and I hope they stay safe.
As we were wrapping up, we noticed one particular guy pestering Noor and creeping her out quite a bit. He looked like the kind of guy who couldn't afford the girls' low prices. As he kept hassling Noor, Novi ran over to us and asked if we'd take Noor home.
Okay, now see you want to go home and we'll drop them.
Yeah. Noor wants to go home too. Yeah, sure.
Yep.
Karena manusia ada yang menjalankan segala macam kebutuhan mereka dan pekerjaan mereka, menjalankan menjual diri, mencuri, menipu, itu semua Tuhan meridhoi. Itu Tuhan telah meridhoi semua.
The next morning we woke up and headed to a small village somewhere outside Yogyakarta. Jamila was getting a black market breast job and agreed to let us come, as long as we didn't film where we were or who was doing the procedure. I knew that it was common for warriors, who believe it makes them look more feminine, to inject silicone into their faces and breasts. Jamila was really excited because although she's had injections in her cheeks and chin, she would be getting boobs for the first time.
Saya memang menambah, saya akuin, tapi kalau saya merubah untuk kepemberian Tuhan, saya tidak akan merubah pemberian Tuhan. Menambah, saya ingin menjadi, saya merasa kayak saya itu perempuan, saya punya payudara. Jadi saya harus mengisi payudara. Kalau operasi kan saya tidak mampu. Waktu itu memang operasi payudara kan mahal sekali. Dan waktu itu saya masih suntik, ya tidak terlalu mahal. Ya tuntutan kayak seperti kita, kayak kita merasa perempuan.
The room was incredibly hot and definitely unsterile. And the side of Jamila's chest growing into two oddly shaped mounds was enough to make both Mendez and I start to feel ill.
Was it painful? Could you feel it?
Ya cuma di itu nyamuk lah, cepet gitu deh.
We needed a little air after witnessing the operation, so we decided to head back to Mariani's and check in with the rest of the warriors. When we arrived, Mariani was getting ready to head out on a scooter with Rizky and told me to hop on. We were heading to the market to buy makeup and accessories for the big party we were throwing the warriors that night. Mariani seemed genuinely excited to get the chance to girl out with me for a bit. She said that tonight was all about celebrating being a warrior and about being comfortable with yourself.
tidak cuma keluar malam saja, tidak cuma ngamen saja, ternyata bisa buka sel, oh ternyata mengerangkul, mengajak teman-teman beribadah. Sebenarnya yang dijaminkan ke masuk surga itu kan orang yang bertakwa kepada Tuhan, kepada Allah Subhanahu wa taala. Bisa dijaminkan surga itu tentang jenis kelamin dan pakaian. Masuk surga atau tidak itu cuma atau tidak itu kan Tuhan yang menentukan, bukan manusia. Pikiranmu gitu.
The warriors were busy getting dolled up for the party, while Mariani instructed her assistant to make me look like the sexiest warrior possible.
So it appears that she is now attaching the other large growth, some kind of tail, head tail. It feels like I've got a giant clump of weed on my head. You like? Yeah.
Kayaknya yang lihat yang kamu tiduran terus kak tanganmu gini, kakimu ngangkang ke atas gitu.
Enggak
apa-apa. Enggak ada. Ojo mono Mas Brono. Nah. Ojo terlalu miring. Nah,
While the girls sat in the schoolroom taking glamour shots on their cell phones and gossiping about cute boys, I noticed that Mariani was sitting quietly in the salon as she applied her makeup.
Dan sekarang saya tidak mau saya punya cowok. Jadi pengalaman saya itu ada waktu dulu sampai sama saya itu senang karena saya bisa memperhatikan dia. Setelah kamu kerja, kamu bisa mau menikah ya saya silahkan tuh. Kan kasihan kalau saya mengekang cowok harus sama saya selamanya, tidak bisa saya. Keinginan saya, tujuan saya membesarkan anak, bekerja, beribadah, udah itu.
And so this bit.
Kangen, ningen rasani. Rindu, tambani. Kutu ketemu.
Wada. All right, we're gonna have to practice that more.
Ever.
What do you think about God? Like, to you, what is God? I'm interested because, you know, I don't know how I feel about it, and I'm always interested to hear other people's opinions.
Ya, Tuhan itu menyayang dengan umatnya. Dan Maha Adil, Maha Kuasa, tinggal manusianya mau menjalankan perintah Allah atau tidak. Saya tidak peduli omongan orang. Yang penting saya waria. Suka omongannya sama-sama kita makan nasi aja.
Hana itu kayak putri keraton dari Jawa.
Bisa lebih natural, alami, ya.
Holy fucking shit. The party was at a restaurant with a stage, sound system, and a resident keyboard player who wanted to know who the new ladyboy was when I walked in. Obviously, Mariani had done a good job on my makeup. The warrior were trying to be on their best behavior, but some of the younger girls were sneaking swigs of booze under the table. It might have helped them with their performance anxiety. The warriors took turns singing and dancing, which involved a lot of Dang Dut and a lot of Celine Dion. I was super impressed by Mariani's numbers. The warriors sang and danced well into the night. I was dragged to the dance floor over and over and did my best to shake it like a Javanese bride. Eventually, I was yanked on stage to perform the love song the warriors had been teaching me.
Terima kasih. Ini tamu kita namanya Mbak Anna dari Australia. Bisa menyanyi ever. Nah ini kangen sama ewer ya.
Abal.
Terima kasih sekali.
Matur nuwun.
Saya juga ingin hidup bisa bermasyarakat dan bisa kayak manusia yang seutuhnya kayak perempuan. Dia bisa rias manten, dia bisa motong dan lain sebagainya, bisa bermasyarakat. Nah, itu kan kita bisa diakui dengan masyarakat.
Even though their situation is far from perfect, I was impressed by the warriors' determination to better themselves, and particularly by Mariani's refusal to play by the rules. It takes a courageous warrior to do what she has, raise a child on her own, reach the pinnacle of warriordom by opening her own beauty salon, and to start the school so that others might do the same. As for the fact that the warrior are dedicated to the very religion that refuses to accept them, I agree with what Mariani told me. Since God is the one that judges whether they go to heaven or hell, it's their relationship with Him that matters, not the opinions of people. With lipstick in their pockets and God on their side, it seems the warriors have a fighting chance.